Hey everyone and good afternoon. Welcome to another edition of Herbs of the Earth Live. My name is Amar and I'll be joined shortly by my partner Shiris in this afternoon's episode of Herbs of the Earth, where we're going to talk about battle gear, your battle gear, as we return to the workforce in this MECQ condition that we're in Metro Manila and many parts of the surrounding areas in Calabarzon. I know for certain that there's a lot of regions already in the Philippines that are on its general community quarantine, but here we are at the capital where it's totally different. And so this afternoon we thought of, you know, talking about how to get, you know, ready for battle as we get back into the workforce. So I hope that you are as excited as I am, as it's gonna be a fantastic afternoon for sure. Okay, so if you're joining us for the first time, this is Herbs of the Earth Live, and we do our live shows every week, twice a week actually, Wednesdays and Saturdays. Sometimes we change it, you know, depending on the streaming partners that we have, because we're right now streaming live via our merchant partner sites and on Facebook Live as well. So thank you guys for joining us. If you're joining us for the first time, don't forget to please follow us on Facebook. That's Herbs of the Earth, facebook.com/herbsoftheearth. Or if you're on Instagram, it's instagram.com/herbsoftheearth or #herbsoftheearth. And we're here basically to answer questions and queries, okay, that you may have when it comes to health, wellness, and well-being, okay? And you know what? Every week we have a topic at hand, basically most of which are actually from our, you know, our viewers, our customers who tune in and say, hey, maybe next week you can talk about this, or maybe, hey, next episode, can you talk about this? And this is a timely topic, honestly, that we're talking about, which is, you know, what do we need to get ready with? What do we have to prepare for before we go to the workforce? And yes, it is a weekend, Saturday, and the government has decided to lift our ECQ today, okay, to an MECQ or a modified enhanced community quarantine. And, you know, there's a lot of industries that are opening up today and the following days to come. 50% of the workforce will be getting to battle once again, you know, after long lockdown, more than 60 days of lockdown. And so, you know, are we ready? Are we ready after, you know, getting or being at home, okay, for a very, very long time? And then suddenly, hey, let's get back to the grind. Let's get back to battle, you know, after being away for a long time. Okay, so that's a topic for this afternoon. And you know, there's a lot of things to cover. And in our live segment, you know, it's an hour long. So stick with us this afternoon for an hour. And I just, you know, I just thank you for you guys who are here with us already. I see a couple of people already tuned in. So, hey, thank you guys for joining us this afternoon, and you know, we're not gonna disappoint you guys, because I think, you know, this getting ready, you know, what to prepare and how to get ready is a very, very important thing. Okay, so before we get to the topic, and while we're waiting for my partner, I just wanted to ask, and you can shout out on those comments, you can write your comments down below what you have been doing during this enhanced community quarantine while at home. Okay, you know, you can just write it down, send it to us, and we can discuss it. You know, I'm gonna give you a shout out. Many of my friends, you know, have during the lockdown have rediscovered, you know, their past passions in life. You know, either they're baking, they're cooking, you know, they're getting back to art and painting. A couple of my friends have begun sculptures, also mini sculptures in their houses. They began to reorganize their furniture. They began to declutter as well, right? Some of my friends have now joined the bandwagon of doing workouts, and exercise at their at the comfort of their homes, especially those who've been used to going to the gym, you know, and now they found a place, I mean a new avenue to actually still work out in their houses even without equipment, okay? And that's amazing, right? A couple of my friends have found their found their passion back in reading, and they've been, you know, just diving deep into books that they have been enjoying when they were in college or when they were in high school, and you know, some of them were reading. So that was crazy, right? A couple of friends of ours have now found the joy of homeschooling as well, because obviously with schools closed, you know, parents very parents have now found another resource, which is homeschooling. We've been homeschooling for a very, very long time already with our four kids, and you know, the joy of homeschooling is totally different. Of course, very daunting at first. I can imagine for first time homeschooling parents, when I was homeschooling, when we were homes, we continued to, when we started homeschooling, it was pretty, I would say, daunting. But because of the support group that is around, and there's a huge homeschooling group, there's a lot of parents who do homeschool, you know, especially in the homeschool program that we're involved in, you know, there's tons of support for you guys out there who's found homeschooling as another option to teach children, right? So yeah, and there are a couple of friends of ours as well who started really serious baking. And what I mean by serious baking, it became a side income already. They found that, hey, they're good at making pastries and cookies and cakes. In fact, you know, here in our neighborhood, here in where we stay, actually, there's a couple of neighbors of ours who are actually really good, you know, bakers, and they just share their produce with the whole community, okay? And of course, they sell it, they share it, they give it away, you know, for you to try and all that. And so what I'm trying to say is, this whole lockdown thing was not all bad in totality, right? Not only in our country, but, you know, in the whole world in general. And of course, that's not to discount the fact that there's a lot of people who lost, you know, family members, relatives, even parents during this lockdown due to the COVID-19. We don't discount that. You know, prayers out to you guys. But in totality, there are still, you know, a lot to be thankful for, right? In spite of what is happening outside. And so, you know, now it's totally different. So we're the ECQ is lifted, became MECQ, and now a lot of our friends, a lot of our customers, a lot of our viewers are finding it, I would say, daunting as well, difficult. Fear may be setting in as to, hey, what do I need to do? What do I need to prepare for to get ready for battle in this new normal, right? So that's crazy. And that's why we decided to talk about this topic this afternoon, okay? So again, you know, get those questions coming in. And just send us a message. We're live on Facebook, and we're live in our merchant partner sites. You can chat with us, and my colleagues are there to answer your queries and questions if we're unable to answer it here in our live segment. Okay, you know, we're live, like I said, in Facebook and our merchant partner sites, and these have their own chat functions and functionality. So honestly, if you can see what I'm looking at right now, I have, you know, several cell phones right here, so I can see in your comments coming in. I have a screen in front of me, so I can see also what is being flashed, what you guys can see. So I can see the comments right there in my screen though, but I can see it on the mobile phones just in front of me. So keep them coming in, okay? So again, if you're joining us for the first time, my name is Amar, and I just want to encourage you to follow us on Facebook or on Instagram. That's facebook.com/herbsoftheearth and on instagram.com/herbsoftheearth, #herbsoftheearth, where we actually give tons of, I would say, freebies and vouchers and discount codes to all those who not only follow us, but also those who love the products of Herbs of the Earth, those who actually purchase our products too, you know, and for the repeat purchase and all those, you know, we give tons of really good freebies for you guys, just to thank you for, you know, for being loyal and just for even just for trying out Herbs of the Earth. Okay, so again, thank you so much, guys, for trying out our products. And hey, finally, I'm joined here by my partner, Cherise. Hey, she just came in the room. I don't know if you heard the door open.
Yes.
So yeah, welcome.
Hi, guys.
Welcome.
Good afternoon. What are you doing on a beautiful Sunday afternoon? A Saturday afternoon. Sunday na ako. Saturday afternoon. You know, they were, how do you say it? They were saying that it was going to be a, what's this? Storm weather.
A stormy
weekend.
Day.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But wow, amazing. The sun is out. So what are you guys up to today? Are you staying at home? Are you going out for grocery?
Or you're going back to work, as I was telling them.
Yes, going back to work.
I was telling them earlier that this is the first day the ECQ is lifted to MECQ. And now,
it
is a weekend, but you know, I'm sure throngs of us will be going to work to the office on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so perfect topic, right? Battle gear.
Battle gear to be battle ready. Okay, and the battle is, of course, this unseen foe, which is COVID-19.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I just got a message saying that, you know, until a vaccine has been found and people, more than 90% of people have been vaccinated, we're still fighting a invisible foe.
Yeah.
But until that time it happens, you know, there's no other way than to protect yourself by strengthening your immune system. What? Strengthening your immune system as well as taking precautionary measures.
Yes.
So that's what we're going to be talking about today. What precautionary measures should you take or should you follow or make sure to do before stepping out into the war zone, which is the outside world.
Right.
Guys, are you raring to go out? Are you so excited already to go back to work? Are you one of the people who are still fighting for the ECQ to be extended so that you don't have to go to work? You know, there are three schools of thought, no? One is, time to go back to work. We have to go back to work. Lift the ECQ. The others are, please do not. We want to be safe and stay home. Don't lift the ECQ yet. And there are people who are in between. I don't know.
Yes, and there are those who have no choice but to go back to work, right? So
That's
a timely topic, right, Cherise? And I was telling them how daunting it is now to just, you know, from being at home
for
60 days and suddenly, man, I need to go out, you know. I need to get back to work. I need to, you know, earn some money again. This is critical, right? And so we're here to help you prepare, guys. And by the way, yesterday I was actually out the whole day.
Yeah.
I went to Metro Manila.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you, there's already a lot of cars in the road. In fact, in the middle of traffic. Yes, there was traffic in the middle of the stoplight. I was counting, hey, there's about, 40 cars just beside, you know, me and around me. And so I can imagine how it's going to be come not only today, but really come Monday, especially since the transport sector is still gearing up and transportation like jeepneys are still not allowed to ply the roads, you know, in the MRT and LRT. And so it will be extra difficult for many of us, right? So, what do we do to prepare?
I'm actually trying to log on to the account so that I can see your messages.
Oh, it's
in
all
real
here.
Time.
We're here. We can see. Yep.
Okay. So, what do we do? How do you prepare yourselves to go into battle? Especially if you have no choice.
Yeah, I have an idea. You talk about how women should prepare, and I'll talk about how men should prepare. getting to the workforce.
Oh, that's actually
right?
good, right? Yeah. Okay, let's start.
Let's start.
Okay, so for women,
you first.
You know, like what I'm wearing right now, jewelry, my hair is down, diba? And I have my rings.
Yeah.
Actually, these are things that you should leave at home. Stick to essentials. Make sure that you leave your jewelry at home because these are other things that you will have to sanitize when you get home, right? Keep your bodies as clean as possible from jewelry or mga burloloys nga ang tawag ng nanay ko dun, burloloys. Diba? Things that you just you can do without. Keep it as simple and as neat as possible, as bare as possible. To avoid having to clean these when you get home. Another thing is to keep, if not, hindi lang babae, kung lalaki ka at mahaba ang buhok mo dahil ECQ, hindi ka na nakapagpagupit.
Oh, yeah. Okay. And salons are still closed, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so if you're one of these people who have long hair like me also, and you can tie it back, make sure to tie it. You know, if you're traveling, you're taking public transport, try to put it under a cap also so that it eliminates exposure to the elements, which is, you know, anything kasi that the virus can stick to, it will stick to. Diba? It's a live virus waiting for its next prey, so it will stay alive when it sticks to a surface, to your hair, to your body. That's why you have to wash your hands. Make sure also that when you wash your hands, you do not forget to wash your wrists as well.
Good.
Or if you'd like to be safer, hugasan po natin hanggang dito sa ating, hindi ko makita siya sa camera. Hanggang dito sa may
elbow.
I was trying to think of it in Filipino.
Braso?
Tuhod ang... Basta, your elbows.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, make sure you wash your hands properly. Dalawang kanta ng maligayang bati if you want to be nationalistic.
Yay.
And make sure to wash your wrists and all the way up to your elbows, guys. That's one thing. How about you for men?
Okay, well, you mentioned it. Jewelry, that's right. You know, men love to wear watches when we go out, right? Of course, for practical reasons, you know, check the time and all that. But you have your phones for that, so it's not the time. I don't think it's the time to wear watches when you go out. So just as Cherise mentioned for the women, I think the same thing, right?
Yeah.
For clothing, I would go for wearing shorter sleeves, you know, so that you can, like what Shay said, you can wash it until the elbows. So short sleeve, and that's why I'm wearing short sleeve, you know, today. Short sleeve and collared shirt, of course, in our workplace, depending on where you work, but you know, short sleeve's perfect. If shorts is allowed in your workplace, amazing if it is. You know, but if it isn't, then comfortable clothes and comfortable shoes is very important. Okay,
yeah, they're very important.
Very important now, especially since transport will be an issue. There's probably going to be a lot of walking around here and there, and if you're on your bikes, literally a bicycle, which is a fantastic mode of transport. Mm-hmm. You know, you gotta wear comfortable pants, pair of pants. And pair of shoes.
Yeah.
Why were you smiling? What's wrong?
Nothing. No, but you know, guys, what we've tried to do so far in the house is before we get into the house, you don't know where the virus is stuck itself on, diba? Or if you went to an area where there's an asymptomatic person, he sneezed or he coughed, and it stuck to your clothes. And there are varying studies about how long a virus can last or live on a surface, depending on the material of the surface. So they say that it can last anywhere from 24 to 72 hours if it's just left that way. So if that's the case, di ba hindi mo alam kung nakadikit na siya sa damit mo, sa sapatos mo, sa kamay mo. With your hands, you can wash anytime. You can sanitize it. We actually did an experiment here at home. We sprayed our doorknob with alcohol, and our doorknob is steel. So you'll see where the alcohol touched it. You'll see the parts where the alcohol dried. It becomes matte and lighter in color. So when we were looking at this, may areas pa rin, kahit ilang beses namin siyang spray, may areas pa rin na naiwan na unsprayed. na hindi nag-lighten yung color. You'll see the dots of alcohol on it. Yeah. And it was not completely covered with alcohol. Mm.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, for such a small item which is sprayed again and again, can you imagine on your clothes? So what we've done in the house is, one, we've made sure to leave our outside shoes outside and leave slippers inside, shoes or slippers for inside use only. Another thing is some people naman, they leave a foot bath or a shoe bath outside, a mat where you can sanitize your shoes.
Yes, and hopefully our workplaces
as well will do
have
that.
Those
yes.
as well. You know, it's not a foot soak, it's a shoe mat.
Soak.
Shoe soak, I guess.
Yes.
A doormat with a disinfectant solution, mm-hmm. you know, so para when you step on it, I guess the sole of our shoes
mm-hmm.
get disinfected. So hopefully
yes.
our workplaces
mm-hmm.
have that as well.
Yes.
You know, if not, maybe your place of work does not have that. Good suggestion,
of course,
to management.
Yes, good suggestion. And there are places already here that actually ask you to bring shoes for inside. To carry your shoes for inside
or
already.
You should do that, right?
Yeah. Dapat talaga iba yung sa labas, iba yung sa loob. Kasi kahit na isanitize mo, kagaya yung nangyari sa doorknobs namin, di ba? Also is, bring your own sanitizer or your own alcohol.
Absolutely important.
Always make sure that it's better
in spray.
It's better in a spray bottle and it's
handy,
so easy.
Yeah.
Handy. Instead of having it in a bottle with a spout lang. Mas mahirap siyang gamitin. Pero ang spray, for example, mas maganda na pong OC ngayon kaysa sa mag-regret, di ba? So before
complacent.
You hold... Yes. Hold before you hold common area. Common hardware like doorknobs and faucets, mas magandang sprayan yun na po muna siya. Okay?
Yes. And, you know, disinfectants, there's a lot
mm-hmm.
out there. Make sure it is really a disinfectant.
Yes.
Hindi lang siya yung hand sanitizer.
Yes, that's right.
If it's a hand sanitizer, make sure that it's one that disinfects. Okay? And
mm-hmm.
If it's alcohol, at least it's 70%
yes.
Isopropyl alcohol.
That's
right.
Right.
To make it, of course, be able to kill those germs,
mm-hmm.
bacteria, viruses in common places or common handles, I would say. Is that what they
mm-hmm.
call it? Okay.
Common hardware.
So we already know, as Charisse mentioned, that, you know, mask is important.
Mm-hmm.
You guys know that already, right? You need your hand sanitizer.
Yes.
Also bring with you some tissue paper or
mm-hmm.
Handkerchief.
A
hanky with you, okay?
Yeah.
So to be able to, you know, when you wash your hands, you can wipe it on your own,
mm-hmm.
you know, hanky or your hand towels or tissue papers.
Yeah.
Very important. Some most likely will also be wearing face shields, okay,
mm-hmm.
or goggles. And for those of you who have glasses already, fantastic, since you have glasses to protect your eyes as well. If you don't have, then hopefully go get a face shield
mm-hmm.
or goggles or, you know, of course, sunglasses.
Protective gear,
as long as there's protective gear to protect our face area.
There are actually so many videos on YouTube right now where you get to make your own protective gear. Things that you find around the house or things that you can buy, you can use recycled items to make it into a new useful product or useful protective gear. Kagaya
yes.
ng mga masks.
Yes.
These are essentials right now, especially if you're going into the battlefield, into back to work, di ba? Right now, guys, hindi na po uso ang beso-beso. Di ba?
Yes.
If you watch that
yes.
movie, 5 feet apart, this movie na she had a stick around with her to make sure that people stayed 5 feet away from
really?
Her. Yeah, she made a stick. So,
weird
you know,
siya dati.
Hindi, kasi kailangan niya kasi meron siyang she was immune compromised and she could not go near, I think it was cystic fibrosis if I'm not mistaken. So, that's actually the new norm. It's so amazing because it was a love story that we now have to follow. We don't necessarily have to bring a stick. If you want, you can.
Oh my gosh.
Pero,
pampalo.
Yung stick
pamalo.
Na yun, tandaan nyo, sasanitize nyo na naman pag-uwi nyo. So, try to gauge how far you have to stay away from people. Diba?
Yeah.
And on that note, let me try to get better. Let me try to connect to our Facebook Live because I cannot see it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. All right. So let me just try and I'll come back, guys.
All right. And, you know, so she was talking about what the men, I mean, the women's, what women should be bringing. It was same through with us men. You know, it may not look, I would say, we're so used to shaking hands, you know, with our friends, especially since you haven't seen them for a long time. It's a colleague at work, you know, or even a relative you haven't seen in a long time, and maybe even, you know, see them while you're going to work. Hindi na uso. It's not advisable to shake hands at the moment, even though we are a country who love to shake hands, make beso, and hug. You know, that's not advisable at the moment since we're all battling this invisible virus, right? So we avoid shaking hands. We avoid, touching surfaces that are frequently touched by others as well. You know, we're talking about handles and all that. You know, try to avoid it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Another thing is maybe you can bring plastic gloves with you. They are inexpensive. You can buy them in the grocery,
mm-hmm.
So that, you know, it's easy to put and it's easy to actually apply it. Unlike the surgical gloves, which are, you know, I tried it myself, very difficult to put in, and I have sweaty hands. So when I take it off, it's all sweaty in that, you know. But at least with gloves, you know, those plastic gloves that are actually, you know, loose, you know, and okay to wear. Don't worry about, you know, opening up yourself because you cannot manipulate them while you're on your way to your workplace. No worries, because when you get to work, then that's a time you can take them off. Don't forget also to sanitize your cell phones, by the way. Some of us neglect maybe even, you know, wiping the surface of our cell phones because either they're not waterproof and all that, you know. You just need to spray a little bit. I'm sure your phones won't get damaged with spritz of sanitizer or, disinfectant, sorry, on the cell phones, right? It's better safe than, you know, the risk of getting this virus. So same true with your workplace. Now, when you finally get to your workplace, right, and hopefully the office has this, what do you call it, soak, you know, shoe soak or the...
Like MCT weed, na okay. Yan, ha? Okay.
Yeah, that's why I'm so hyper this afternoon, you know?
Guys, kayo, meron ba kayong, do you guys have hacks or do you guys have things that you've read on? You know, we can see you in real time. We can see your comments in real time and we would love to hear from you. Hindi naman talaga real time. There's a five second lag delay, but as soon as we get it and you have questions, you have comments, you have suggestions, please type it in. We love hearing from you guys also. And we can see that there are 86 people right now watching on Lazada.
Mm-hmm.
Ayan, si RD, may tips ba kayo for alternative disinfectant? You know, vinegar is actually a good disinfectant also. Is it enough to kill the virus? There's no study on it, but you can actually mix it with alcohol. Kung kulang kayo sa alcohol, pwede yung i-mix yung suka, alcohol, konting tubig. And that's what you can bring along with you. Another thing, if you have essential oils at home, meron ba kayong tea tree? Meron ba kayong any disinfectant? You know, oils are natural disinfectants. They are antibacterial, so they kill bacteria and viruses. They're mm-hmm. antiviral. So you can mix this also, or make sure you bring peppermint. Peppermint is amazing also.
You can mix a couple of oils to make your own disinfectants.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you for that question.
There is the challenge of mixing, obviously, oil with water, right?
So
you mix it with alcohol first. Mm. The oil with alcohol first, and then that's when you can mix it with a little bit of water. So there's tons of dilution mechanisms, I would say, that you can find on the internet on how you can make your own disinfectant spray. And when in doubt, just go ahead with alcohol, okay? Alcohol in itself
mm-hmm.
is a disinfectant. Just make sure it's 70%
alcohol.
Isopropyl alcohol.
You know,
okay?
People have actually started to make San Miguel a year has made their plan.
Yeah, you know,
alcohol
that's
plan.
Yeah.
So that's,
a lot of processing
mm-hmm.
plants, manufacturing facilities
yes.
have then now reverted to
turn
their facilities to alcohol manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
So alcohols are actually available now, unlike
before
when
MECQ started.
March
yeah.
and April where
yeah.
people were hoarding. So yeah, alcohol is a perfect disinfectant. Okay.
Yes. And kudos to the government for banning or for how do you say that? Pag pinagalitan mo. For
limiting, hoarding,
for making
penalizing
sure,
those
penalizing,
who
yes,
hoard and all that.
Yes.
You know?
So
now you're in the workplace,
now.
Right?
Now
you're in the workplace and you've disinfected your workplace.
Mm-hmm.
How do you disinfect your workplace? Imagine you haven't seen your workstation for a long time and hopefully
yeah.
your company have done
yeah.
steps
mm-hmm.
already to disinfect the office and all that. But, you know, if I were you, I'd still disinfect my workstation when I get there just to be sure, you know, that you're all good and fine, right?
Mm-hmm.
So with your disinfectant spray, you know, go ahead and just, you know, wipe your table. Sit like we suggested earlier, bring your own tissue paper and all that. You disinfect your workplace. And you know who's best with disinfecting? She is. So hear from her when it comes to disinfecting the workplace.
You know, if you work with keyboards, if you're a call center agent or if your work is mostly online, you know, the best thing to do is always you can bring your own keyboard and mouse, because at least you're sure where it has been and whose hands have touched this. So that's one thing. But if you have no other way, then the best way is to spray your work area, leave it for 5 minutes untouched, and then you can wipe it off already before putting on your monitor or plugging it in. Make sure to let it stand for at least 5 minutes so that whatever is there, it dies already. And then if you want, you can spray it again and then just wipe it off.
Yep.
Alcohol will dehydrate whatever it touches. So, makikita nyo magdi-discolor yung inyong gamit.
For some, depends on the quality also of the alcohol.
But then, it's better
purchased.
It's better to be safe than sorry. Spray your monitor, spray your table, spray your pens, the things that you're going to be using.
Right.
Because when you start working, you'll notice that when your mind is fixated or focused on what you're doing, nakakalimutan mo what your hands will be doing. So,
minsan,
mahahawakan mo na yung mata mo, mahahawakan mo yung ilong mo. So, every time you remember, have your spray of alcohol beside you and just keep spraying your hands throughout the day if you cannot get up. And before you touch food, guys, if you're going to go on break, make sure you wash your hands and spray the table where you will be eating. We spray everything already right now. When Amar goes to the grocery, hindi siya umuupo dun sa mga lines because, syempre, you don't know kung sino at kung saan din nang galing yung mga nakaupo dun. Diba? Yung umupo previously to you. So, it's always better to be safe and sacrifice for a bit than be sorry. We have a lot of small sprays from our mga sanitizers na mga dala-dala namin.
Mga ubus na.
Ubus na.
Empty bottles,
yes.
Right.
And these ones, we refill. So
yes.
It's all over the workplace, it's all over the house also. Para siguradong basta madaanan, oo nga pala, hindi
yeah,
para
spray. Spray, spray, spray.
Yes, when in lack, spray. If you don't have a sink to go to, you don't have soap, spray, di ba?
Yeah. And spray enough na yung tumutulo na siya, you know. Sometimes it's not enough to just spray. Like the example that Cherise mentioned a while ago with the doorknob, you see that it's not the whole thing, you know. So, of course, spray
and
diligently.
Rub
diligently, very
yes.
important. Avoid sharing of office
materials mm-hmm.
also, di ba?
Yes.
So that we avoid spreading also this bacteria, this virus, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is just, again, for now, right? This is the new normal, guys. And of course, we need to protect each other. It's not about, you know, I don't want to share. And it's not the question that we're talking about here. It's just really being clean
yes.
and sanitary, you know, and just doing our fair share of protecting ourselves and our colleagues as well in the office.
Hello, Milet. Okay? Milet says, hello po. Tap, tap. Hello. Hi po. Hi, Milet. Do you have any questions that you would like to ask? If you're just tuning in to us right now, we are talking about battle gear for the battlefield. So what ways can you protect yourself if you are going back and when you go back to work after this ECQ? As Amar mentioned, this is the first day that we are on MECQ. For other areas, congratulations, you are on GCQ. So what ways or what are the ways that you can protect yourself? Again, this is Amar and I'm Cherise, and we are talking about that today. If it's something that you know you are interested in, please continue to view or to continue to watch. If this is something that you know your friends and your family might have someone in mind, call them right now and tell them to tune in, send them the link. Diba? So we are live on Facebook and we are live on Lazada. Mm-hmm. Dave Anthony says, discipline is key. That's right.
Discipline is key. Yep, that's true.
Yes, it takes 21 days to make or break a habit. If you continue doing it diligently for 21 days, masasanay ka na rin. Sabi nga nila, ito ang ating new normal.
Yeah. So, and, you know, so that's true. Thanks, Dave, for mentioning that. You know, we've been cocooned.
Ah, okay. Combination po yan ng kahon, nakakahon sa bahay, at cocoon sa bahay. So, kahund. That's a new word.
We are kahund in our houses for a long time, which causes this, you know, mental slur.
Yes.
In me. So, there are habits at home that we don't want to bring to the workplace. That's what I'm trying to say, right? Like, we're not wearing masks in our houses, right? But this is something that we need to do when we go out in the workplace, right? So, you know, before going out, try wearing those masks already. Yeah. In the household pa lang, wear those masks na. Because if you're wearing it for the first time or, you know, you haven't worn it, and this time you're going to go to the workplace and you're going to wear it the whole day, it's really, really tough.
It takes honestly, a lot it takes, of getting used to.
Especially, you know, breathing in.
Yeah.
The warmth of your own breath, you know, and if you haven't brushed your teeth, the smell of your own breath.
RD says, ha ha ha, kahun. RD, bago yung idadagdag.
Yeah, taglish yan, taglish.
But you know, guys, speaking of masks,
fair number of masks, yes. You know, with you, and these are, of course, disposable masks.
Yes.
You can go with those that you can washable. Wash, of course, yeah.
Yes, and the thicker ones, the N95 ones. You know, when we traveled.
So we have a couple of.
When we traveled to the States,
this one was from our, you know, given barangay. By our barangay. Imagine beautifully colored mask. So
when we traveled to the States prior to the pandemic, on the way back and on the way to the States, we actually wore this kind of mask. Yeah, this is the N95. This is the 3M brand na sobrang kapal. So actually, thick. Ang sakit niya sa tengang gamitin.
It's painful after a long time. Yeah.
So, this is something that our frontliners wear every day. That's why ang daming nagdo-donate ngayon. Yung, it's the strap that you put in the back to keep the
like your sister made, knitted some actually. That's beautiful.
Crocheted, yeah. When we were on the way to, we were in the plane. It was very difficult to wear. But you know, in our mind kasi, it was a way for us to protect ourselves. So if that's your mindset, kailangan tong gawin para hindi magsisi at hindi mahirapan pag in the future, you know. It's so difficult to be stricken with COVID-19. It's such a painful disease. Not just physically, but emotionally as well. Kasi you are taken away from your loved ones. It's difficult. It's different when you are sick and may tagabantay sa'yo na alam mo, kilala mo, mauutusan mo.
Yeah.
As compared to going, being forced to go to a hospital or to an area where you are a PUI or PUM and not be able to fraternize, not be able to socialize or talk man lang to your family because wala, you are asked to leave, diba? You're asked to stay away. Tapos yung mga frontliners natin, with the amount of people, the number of cases that you're handling, they cannot stay with you the whole day and cater to each and every need you have. So you're already fighting a disease, but you're also fighting loneliness and being excluded from your family. So if this is something, if this mask is a sacrifice, this should be a sacrifice we should all be willing to take. It's not just taking care of ourselves, but it's also making sure that the other people around us are not affected. We don't bring anything home to our loved ones, especially if you have the older ones and the younger ones. They are so susceptible to this. So please, let us try.
Ito na yung tiis natin. Ito na yung tiis.
Hindi na siya tiis ganda. Mm-hmm. Tiis buhay na po siya.
Some
diba?
People wear their masks, tapos makikita mo naman nakagano.
Yeah. So, may naalala akong meme to. Para
lang maka-breathe. So it's totally wrong, guys.
Yes.
Okay.
How do you use it?
Really covered, you know. Mm-hmm. You got that spring has to form well in the mouth, you know, in the the neck.
So the ones that they're actually making, which you can crochet or knit at home.
Yeah.
It's just a strip with two buttons on either side. Just a short one. Ilalagay mo siya dito. So one button goes through this and another through here, and it'll hold it away from your ear.
Yeah.
It's dual purpose because it protects the back of your ear, your earlobe, which is very sensitive, and it also keeps the mask stretched around your nose. So baka ito na rin ang new normal namin, ganito na kami magda-live next time. Naka-cover na rin.
So wear it all the way, right? Wear it all the way. And if your colleague is not, then say, "Hey guys, wear the mask," or give them another one, you know, and I'm sure many of our workplaces will be sure to provide these masks. You know, but you know, get yourselves some as well. I know that there are a couple of merchants who are taking advantage, you know, and selling them for a hefty
price.
You know, so of course you can make your own mask. Also, there's a lot out there, and these are good. You know, you can, of course, yun. Oh, diba? Ganda pa nung binigay ng barangay namin.
Sabi ni Dave, tama Dave, when the COVID started, the Philippines was just recovering or was in the middle of the Taal explosion.
Yes.
So the masks, nag-run out na siya bago pa nag-COVID-19. But, you know, we praise God that companies have stepped up, people, other countries have started to donate also, and we have masks again available, and not for a hefty price. I remember we bought our masks at I think 500 or 600 each.
Yeah, the height when we were in
when you're on our way to travel, and that was something that, you know, we had to just swallow and just take. Pero now, with everybody's efforts, so many people are also donating masks to our frontliners. So praise God for that, Dave. Diba, ngayon mas accessible na, mas madali nang makakuha ng mask. But if you're still looking, you know, you check Shopee, check Lazada, check online also. Marami nang
check available. Facebook, there's a lot of people who are selling, but you know, to
make
be
sure.
You get from legitimate sources, guys, okay? So that you're protected. Because, of course, a lot of people also take advantage and they may make below standard masks. And instead of protecting you, it's actually causing more harm than good. So, you know.
Mm-hmm. And Judith Castillo, actually, which has nothing to do with our mask. Pero biotin na tayo. Biotin, Judith, our biotin is actually formulated for 18 people. Adults 18 years and above. If you're thinking of giving your teenager this, it's always better to ask your doctor first, your healthcare professional, if the strength or the amount of biotin our supplement contains is okay for your son or your daughter. So always seek medical advice first. Shout out to Princess Joy Inobio. Hi, Princess Joy. Good afternoon. Happy Saturday. Welcome to our live.
All right, so now you're in the workplace and you're ready to go home after work the whole day. Mm. So what are you supposed to do when you finally get home? Okay? Mm. Yeah.
Okay.
Women.
So sa amin, when you get home, we have put a spot already in front of the house. Sa front door pa lang, where you can deposit your clothes. Okay? Huwag naman yung hubad kang maglalakad. Natawa ka bigla.
Yeah, because doon ka naman. Yes. Di ba, nasa labas ka ng bahay mo, sa harap ng neighbors, tapos doon ka nagtatanggal ng mga damit mo.
If if you cannot leave your clothes outside, make sure to stay away from
your kids, your spouses, yes. People in your house first.
Yes. Yeah. Make sure to touch as little as possible, if nothing at all, di ba? Huwag nyo hahawakan yung tuwalya nyo habang suot nyo pa yung damit nyo kasi natatransfer din.
Yeah, diretso ka na sa CR.
Diretso, tanggal ng damit, lagay na sa lalagyan, huwag nyo na pong itapon yung mga damit nyo kung saan-saan ang pangkunas. After maligo!
Or put it in a plastic bag, right?
Or your
take your clothes
bin.
Off, put it in a, yeah, or your bin, plastic bag yeah. It, you know. Make sure you don't put inside the shoes that you wore outside yes. into the house. Of course, you know, take off your shoes. If you're not used to that, a lot of houses don't do that. They just, you know, just go in the house. You know, you're in your condo. But hey, this is a time to really change habits,
yes.
change the norm as well.
That's
so
right.
Take off your shoes, leave it outside because these are those that are, you know, totally exposed,
yeah.
you know, to a lot of things. And so take them off. Yeah. Don't bring it inside your houses.
Now, if you have the, if you have a car, if you're going to be, if you have your own private
vehicle,
yes, mode of transport, as can think, mode of transport, and you want to make sure that you don't take anything from the workplace into your car or into your motorcycle or whatever, you can actually change already while in the office. Pero tandaan nyo, ingatan nyo din kung ano yung matatamaan nyo on the way out. Alangan naman, nagpalit na kayo, upo pa rin kayo sa workstation, you're thinking that you're okay and then you bring it to your car. But no, make sure that you expose yourself as little as possible. Even going to work, you know, being as in the workplace pa lang, being a social butterfly is not what you need right now. It's a no-no right now. So please, try not to go around as much as possible. Stick to your workplace, stick to your desk, stick to your office. It will save you and also protect you as well.
Yep.
Okay. Another thing, go ahead.
What was I gonna say?
No. So when you get home.
All that I'm saying, yeah, when you get home. I think really like what I would do seriously, as soon as I get home, take a bath.
Yes.
You know, and spend a little more time in the toilet just, you know, soaping and cleaning and rinsing well, of course. And then changing clothes before saying or hugging your kids.
Yes.
You know, and your spouse. Because that's, you know, that's exactly what we do in our house as well. And it has worked well for us because
yes.
I don't often go out, but if I need to go out, like for grocery,
yeah.
of course, and whatever work I need to do,
mm-hmm.
I still do the same thing. But now, like I said, this is a new normal, MECQ, now modified. We need to go to work, right? And so this is going to be a daily habit that we need to be doing. You know?
Yes.
And so it's really critical that we, as what's his name, Dave mentioned, the discipline of doing it is really
key.
Important. Yeah.
Keep your hands off your phone, especially when you're outside, or keep disinfecting it from time to time. This is from Dave again. That's actually right. You know, if you can leave your phone somewhere, you will not touch it throughout the day. Para hindi siya ma-expose na naman sa bacteria, sa virus, sa germs. Tapos ilabas nyo na lang siya pag nasa bahay na kayo or nasa kotse na kayo. Sa amin always is we make sure that we leave our phones untouched as much as possible. Kasi kung emergency yan, tatawagan na tatawagan ka. So, we won't touch it unless emergency siya. Yung mga uso before na pag kumakain, nanonood ng Netflix or nanonood ng YouTube, siguro na sobrahan na tayo sa Netflix at YouTube nung ECQ. Tama ba? Na we can actually do it at home already. You know, one thing that's worth mentioning.
Okay.
Guys,
when you are,
let me digress a bit. When you are in the office pa, it is better to bring your own food.
Magbaon
na lang kayo kaysa kumain sa labas or mag-take out. Because you never know how safe it is. Diba? And when you're outside, you cannot naman transfer it to another plate or another spoon and fork or use another spoon and fork. mas maganda siyang alam mo talaga kung saan galing yung kinakain mo.
So nice to bring your own utensils,
diba? Baon, diba? Balik tayo sa high school, sa grade school.
Oh yeah.
Baon nice. Tayo ng food. Not only do you know what food you are eating, but you also know how clean it is and how it was right. handled. Kasi kayo lang ang nag-handle. So when you bring
kung
your...
Kung kayo lang nag-handle.
Kung, when, or kilala lang yung nag-handle. When you bring your food, make sure that you seal it. You pack it in a plastic bag and do not bring it out anywhere else unless you are going to eat it already. Microwaving, a lot of people have opted to microwave their food Ooh. Or reheat it. Sabi nila pag kinain daw nila, pinapainit nila. Pero you know, it's always better to be safe than sorry.
Right.
Okay.
And so...
J.Lu. I don't know kung anong inaan ni J.Lu. J.Lu, ano yung ina mo?
yung ano, yung parang balik high school baon. I love that. You know, yeah. I remember in high school, hindi ako nagbabaon pala in high school. Mm-hmm. I take the jeep back home, eat, and then go back. But I remember in my grade school days, baon, di ba? Share baon with friends. But now,
no sharing.
We can't do that again. Own utensils, own food, and you're gonna be... You know, probably getting used to even in restaurants because right now restaurants can only offer takeout, right?
Yeah.
And so when you're in the workplace and there's restaurants who's gonna offer takeout, of course, you know, sanitize. In fact, the food packaging as well when you receive them and get that handy tissue available, handy sanitizer available.
Yes.
Even if the delivery personnel already brought it to you and they already say it's sanitized and they already say it's okay na, ready to go. You know, better safe at this point in time. Okay, that's why that was our first advice apart from having your mask or your face shield or your goggles. You have your disinfectant. These are your gears, right?
Yeah.
And your tissue paper
your
hanky.
Yeah.
You know, all of these are our weapons, toolkit, so to speak.
You know, I actually do not agree with the handkerchief.
Okay.
Because this is something that you will hold on to, put it close to you. Tapos minsan hindi mo naaalala kung paano gamitin. Kung nagamit, na malinis ba yung kamay ko nung hinawakan ko siya, ano bang nahawakan ko. So, nare-recycle. Anything that you recycle right now is something that is not good as a weapon when you go out. Even, you know, I was reading up on gloves, plastic gloves and rubber gloves. What happens is people actually forget they have gloves on and they forget they touch their eyes. They feel when they are aware of what their gloves are touching, mas, di ba, ito hawakan mo yung grocery mo, lalo na when you're doing the grocery, you have your hands with the gloves and you touch your groceries thinking na, safe ako, I can put it here. And then, while you're waiting in line, you forget na naka-gloves ka, you bring out your phone, or you fix your glasses, or you touch your eyes, or meron yung picture na nakuhanan, he was actually eating fries with his gloves. So, always be mindful. Don't forget that it is an invisible foe. So it's not like it comes in colored hues na blue siya ngayon, purple siya bukas, mas nakikita niyo. No, since it's invisible, you don't know where it is and who it's on. So be mindful, guys. So now we're done talking about what gear, physical gear you can bring with you. How about your insides?
Mm-hmm.
How do you make sure that you are ready?
How do you prepare? Yep.
Yes, that you are ready not just outside but also inside, meaning your body is ready for battle.
Right. So of course we know already the basic supplements to be taking with you: vitamin C, your vitamin D3, your multivitamin if you have them, zinc if you're taking zinc, minerals plus, and even magnesium.
Yeah.
All of these are immune boosting supplements. That we've talked about in our previous live segments and how to boost your immune system and get ready with your, and get ready for work. Mm-hmm. But this day, we're going to talk about one that's particular for in the workplace, okay? Because we need to boost our immune system and also boost our brain functions, right? if you need to be mindful of what you're doing and be more, I would say, conscious, more intentional, and more, I would say, intelligent in managing all of these things, the new normal that we're experiencing, we need some brain power apart from immune boosting, right? And so we thought of it together. What's a perfect supplement that could boost memory function, especially since maybe it has been hibernating for a long time in our kahuning homes.
Case in point, Amar.
and then suddenly we're back in the workplace. You know, we gotta get used to new things again.
Okay? Yes. And before we go into that, I'd like to say a supplement. Shout out to Sweetheart. Yeah, okay. Sweetheart says, wala po bang voucher and free shipping. You know, tune in until the very last minute of our segment.
Yes.
And because we will be giving out discount voucher codes that you can use.
Alright.
Okay.
Oh, seryoso, tune in.
Seryoso.
Okay. Hi, Deandra.
Yeah, hi, dudes. Thank you for watching.
Yes, so, you know, we've talked about, like I said, we've talked about supplements that will boost your immune system in our previous live segment. But this time, we're going to talk about something more specific for the workplace. And this is one of our favorites, actually. It's called MCT.
Oil. Okay, MCT actually stands for medium chain triglycerides. You know, if you were watching our previous segment, our previous live episodes, we've talked about this, but not in exact detail. Okay, so this is something that is perfect for those of you who are, sabi nga nila parang nangangamote or na, like he said, di ba, na hindi nangangamote, na kakaroon na ng cobwebs yung ulo, di ba? As you get older,
yung utak, sabi nga,
utak. Sabi nga nila, may mom brain, may senior moments,
okay.
Merong nagsispace out.
Okay.
And there's so many people who actually reach for a cup of coffee as soon as they wake up,
yeah,
because
true.
They need to wake themselves up, their brains up. So MCT oil, think of coffee but on hyperdrive. So okay. Wala siyang, you feel when you take coffee kasi you feel the sudden surge of energy, parang uy gising, di ba? Wala siyang downward
yung kape jump. Meron yung
ang kape kasi it's like sugar. Sugar, when you take it, you have your sugar high, which you feel so energetic right after you take it. And then after a few hours or minutes or half an hour, biglang nafe-feel mong nagbumababa na yung energy level.
Mm-hmm.
With MCT, it actually boosts your body. If you look at the screen right now, it says boost your body because it really is a body and brain boost.
Yep.
It is your brain on steroids, but these are natural steroids. Okay, so MCT oil is actually found in coconut oil, but they choose the medium chain. So there's short chain, there's long chain, and there's medium chain. So medium chain specifically capric and caprylic acid.
Whoa!
Yes.
Science.
Yes.
Fantastic.
So this one, they take it and they encapsulate it, and you know you feel it. Almost
depends, yeah.
Yeah.
Depends on your physiology. But you know, some would
almost
feel it
immediately.
Some feel it almost immediately, some would take time, okay, maybe after 15 minutes. Some maybe even after 30 minutes.
Dave said, okay. Are we talking about me right now? Yes, you, me and Amar, Dave, and many others out there right now.
Yeah, but one thing I like about this MCT and why a lot of our customers also love this, it's not only really a brain booster, immune boosting supplement, but also it's a fat burner.
Yes.
And that's why we chose this particular supplement. Kasi nga, you know, we've been kahuning.
Such a word.
We've been cocooned in our homes for a long time and eating, you know, whatever is within reach. Anytime we want, we would like to. And so a lot of us, you know, have gained weight. I have gained weight myself, you know. And so a perfect supplement for the brain, getting back to work, increase your energy, and of course, help you lose weight as
are
well.
You, are you doing keto? Are you on the ketogenic diet? Then this is perfect for you also because it is sugar-free and it is oil-based.
Yep.
So, many people choose to take the it's in capsule form. Let me open one for you. So, it's in capsule form. Okay. So, you'll see it's liquid inside. Nawawala yung face ko.
You come close.
Let me go close. Okay.
There you go.
Okay. So, you will see that it is in capsule form. Okay. And many people opt to open the capsule and mix it with their coffee. Amar likes it that way. He actually does it every day. So, he mixes it with his coffee. I personally do not like it. So, for people like me who don't like a different taste in their coffee, this is perfect for you kasi naka-capsule na siya. So, all you have to do is just take it.
Yeah.
For those of you who are doing intermittent fasting like me, yes, Dave, ayan, no? Kasi sabi nga, intermediate. Ano yun?
Intermediate fasting. Maybe that's also what they call it.
Ayan, ano yun? I don't know what that is, ha? But Deandra is a coffee addict, but I get anxiety. MCT oil is perfect for working. Yes, it is, Deandra. So, if you don't want that downward spiral, ayaw mo nang mag-coffee, you can actually take it as a stand-alone as well. So, what do? You just take, if you are doing intermittent fasting like me and Amar, you can take it before your first meal. Since it is sugar-free, safe naman siya, pero it's all, mas maganda siyang safe kayo. And sorry, so instead of breaking your fast earlier, take it before your meal. You can take it with your meal. You can take it after your meal. So how many do you take in a day?
There na siya. 4.
Recommended daw siya. Ang ganda naman yung pagkagawa ng ating,
Nice, right?
Yeah, very nice. Do you guys like the slide? Because I like how the slide is done. And I would like to thank
Larry.
Yes.
Right? What did you
see? Larry. Larry.
Yeah, our colleague Larry does all of these wonderful graphics for us, So, yeah, there you go. 4 liquid capsules, preferably with meals. Yes.
Or diluted with beverages.
You know, and beverages, you were talking about, me putting it in my coffee. I also tried it with tea.
Mm.
I also tried, just this morning, I tried it with tea from Malaysia.
Yeah,
it's like tetarik, but it has, I would say, more cumin-y taste.
Yeah, Dave just said
and that, I put it with the MCT oil, and it was okay. I mean, I think coffee would be the perfect partner of MCT combination, I've tried it with juices. Okay. I think really coffee, perfect.
Perfect combination.
Tea, I've tried it. Or, if you don't want it. Yeah, you don't want it with a beverage, then you can just take it on its own. And that's why the liquid caps are perfect. If you don't want the taste of oil, diba?
Which I do not. I really do not like oily food. And when you take it in encapsulated, it actually, the capsules melt in your gut already. So, hindi siya like here na naiipit. And then, it's very easy to take it. It's not a small capsule. But since it is it's liquid inside and the capsule is veggie cap? This is a veggie cap, ba?
Check.
It's very easy to take. Okay?
These are liquid caps,
Dave sabi niya, wrong spelling daw yung intermediate. Sabi ko, kala ko ito's a new thing. There's so many fasts, there's so many diets right now that it's so difficult to keep track. But with us, kasi we've stuck to IF, we've been doing it for 2 years already. It has worked for us, not just because we want to lose weight, but because it has strengthened our immune system. It helps battle PMS also, migraines also. It brings down your cholesterol level.
We're talking about intermittent fasting.
Yeah, IF. So, we actually talked about that in our previous live segments. And if you would like us to talk about that again, just message it. Kasi medyo matagal na yun na pinag-usapan.
Yeah, we've been doing this for, 2 years already?
Yeah. Wow.
2 years already that we haven't had or we don't take breakfast at all. Mm. So yes, it's been really good for us, and MCT oil helps that help I would say augment the much needed nutrients that our bodies need, especially for the brain. Okay, so getting back to work and getting back to the grind in this new normal, war outside, MCT is a perfect partner or a perfect tool that should be part of our tool kit, okay?
Yes.
So one bottle contains 120 liquid caps.
Which are all non-GMO.
Yep.
So nothing genetically modified inside each capsule.
Yep.
It is also all natural. So guys, you don't have to worry about chemicals, bringing chemicals into your body. So it is all natural, right? Ah, wow, that dedication, yes. You know, Dave, after you get used to intermittent fasting, nasasanay na yung katawan mo, you actually do not look for your breakfast anymore. So, we pray for you na matuloy-tuloy mo yung intermittent fasting. Come back to us and tell us how it works for you. Kasi sa amin, it's done wonders to our health.
Yeah, so what do customers say about our MCT oil? You know, 4.8 out of 5 stars.
Yeah.
Pretty good, pretty good.
98% of that is 5-star ratings, yay, guys.
And
right?
94% positive product experience.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's read through these. If you watched our last episode, episodes way back, I talked about my favorite supplements. Mm-hmm. Yun yung inabandon ako ni Amar kasi meron ata siyang meeting and I had to do live on my own. And I wanted to talk.
That.
Yeah, and that was the first time I did a live segment on my own, a live episode on my own. And I wanted to talk about something that I was aware of or that I was used to or that came from the heart. And I talked about my favorite supplements that I cannot do without on a daily basis. And this was one of them. And I heard about this way, way back from my sister-in-law.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and she was saying how she takes it with her coffee and it actually helps her throughout her day. She's in the States. And when you're in the States, di ba, ang dire-diretso yung trabaho. Hindi kagaya dito na you hold down one job and you're okay. There, you hold down multiple jobs and you have to be on point all the time. So sa kanya, she takes the MCT oil to keep her brain on point.
Nice.
And to keep her stamina, her energy levels up also. And it has done wonders for her. So when I tried it, it actually really does work. But guys, make sure you don't take it after 5 p.m. Kasi gising na gising
kayo. Yeah, so that's why it's perfect as a part of your toolkit when you go out to the workplace. Because this is really for workaholics like me and Cherise. Okay, so here's testimony. Second purchase, always well packaged. I like this better than the current MCT oil that I am using. Nakaka-suppress talaga.
Wow. Hunger pangs. Wow.
I could go 2-3 days of water fasting. Wow that's fantastic.
Amazing.
This is my second purchase. Second bottle. Sorry. Excellent quality as expected. Thank you, seller.
Thank you also. Thank you so
reviewing
much.
Reviewing twice because I purchased it twice. Loving this product, right? Oh, cute. My personalized message pa.
Yes, it's actually my writing.
These messages, are from her.
Mm-hmm.
Signed by her right there. Just to thank you guys for trying out our products and sending us a shout out like that one there. Cute. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I remember there was one who sent out a thank you and said, yo, may pa-note pa si Mayora. Sabi, that was so funny.
Actually, you know, it's so heartwarming to get messages from you guys. To see these recommendations and these reviews are something that our team, you know, when we get a new one, we cascade it to our team immediately. Kahit gaano kaliit, kahit sa message lang, sa messenger at sabihin, salamat, ang bilis na karating, nagulat ako, or I'm so excited to try it. These things, we actually cascade it because it makes us feel like, hey, we are doing something to help others also. And that's the major thing that is our driving force here at Herbs of the Earth, is to make sure that we really promote and help you achieve wellness and well-being.
Yes.
Wellness and well-being.
And well-being, and that's why MCT should be part of your toolkit, guys. It's currently actually on sale right now, so why don't you go ahead and try a bottle of MCT oil delivered right to you if you purchase through our merchant site, or of course on our website, www.wellbeing.com. herbsoftheearth.com where we also offer you guys same-day delivery options. Mm-hmm. Of course,
same that's day with or a, next day
that's delivery, with a cutoff yes. at 12 p.m. So if your orders are in before 12 p.m., on the same day, we're going to deliver it.
Yes.
Except on Sundays, which is
our rest day and our praise and worship day.
Church day,
yeah.
yes.
So Kim E says, because the price is competitive, I thought I should consider buying it. I made the right decision because the oil is encapsulated, which means yeah. you can easily bring some when you travel compared if you buy the ones in a bottle. That's right. If you like the feeling of oil on your bullet coffee, you can just open the capsule and mix the oil on your drink. Exactly what you were saying a while ago. We'll definitely buy again. So, guys, you have got to try our MCT oil. And if you are back to the grind, back to the workforce, you know, not ngayon na MECQ, or work from home pa rin kayo at mahirap magising. Mahirap magstay nagising at alert, lalo na pagkatabi nyo lang yung TV at yung couch nyo ay tinatawag yung pangalan nyo. The answer, the solution for you is MCT oil.
MCT
so,
oil, yeah.
Dave, include mo na si MCT oil sa iyong IF. Okay, it'll help you get through your hunger pangs.
Yep.
And not only that, it will give you the energy and brain boost that your body also needs.
All right. So, again, for those of you who's going to try it out, add it to cart right now.
Yes.
And you know what? Send us a chat message mm-hmm. and say, hey, and say, tell us that you watched this episode.
Yeah.
And so that we're going to send you a freebie. Okay.
Yes.
We're not going to announce the freebie here so that you're going to be surprised, but it's going to be one of our protein bars that we always give out as a freebie, but the flavor is going to be, you know, mixed and matched so that you guys can come back to us and say, hey, I tried it out and I bought your MCT oil. I mean, sorry, you carded it and you're buying your MCT oil so that we
yeah.
can include it in your package. Okay, order it via our merchant partner sites or through our website, www.herbsoftheearth.com, so that you can bring this supplement with you to the workplace so you can take it of course while at work.
That's right. Okay. You know guys, we have had such an amazing response even to the freebies that we give away that people actually come back to our site and buy the freebie itself.
Oh,
these
yeah.
bars, these protein bars are amazing.
True.
So much so that I actually hoard some in the cabinet beside my desk, in the drawers beside my desk. Kasi pag gutom kayo and you're looking for a healthier alternative,
yeah.
then instead of reaching for chips or for chocolates, this is the perfect thing for you. Kung ikaw ay kagaya ko, may sweet tooth at naghahanap ka ng pampawala nung cravings mo. The protein bars that we will be giving out as freebies.
Yes.
What exactly? Well, it's a surprise and mixed mystery box. When you open your package, may makikita kayo dun sa loob. Wen is saying, is it safe for people who undergo keto diet? Yes, it's actually perfect for those who are doing the ketogenic diet.
Yep.
Because it is oil-based and it is sugar-free. So, di ba yun ang mga pinapaingatan na hindi mo itatake is anything with sugar. And this is oil-based. So, yes, perfect for those who are on a ketogenic diet.
All right. So, you know, we're about over... We've overtimed is what I was going to say.
We've gone overtime.
We've gone overtime. Like what we do in the workplace as well, right? But before we want to end our segment, we just want to say thank you guys for joining us this afternoon. What's that?
It's a heart. So instead of doing your beso-beso na yon, you want a small heart, nagturuan. Sino nagturo sa akin ito? Ah, si Eunice.
No,
si Eunice.
Si Eunice.
Okay. This is a small heart and this is a big heart.
Okay.
Okay, and this is flying heart. So all three are going out to everyone who watched and who will be watching on replay.
Yes.
Keep the questions coming in. Reach out
yes.
to us. Thank you so much, Dave, for all of your comments. You know,
yep.
we appreciate that. Thank you to Wang and to RD also who posted their questions.
Thank
Shout
you
out
for
to
Deandra
everyone.
As well.
Thank you for Deandra for watching, guys. Si Deandra single yan.
Sandali lang. Okay, we're Herbs of the Earth and we only talk about health, wellness, yes, and well-being. That's right. And so we thank you guys for joining us this afternoon. My name is Amar, and here's my partner, Cherise.
Yes.
And we hope that you can join us again next week in our next episode. And we're going to be announcing again the topic that we're going to talk about. So tune in. Sorry, not tune in, but, you know, log into
our... Watch out for that. Yeah, guys. If you
log
haven't...
Log into our merchant partner sites and, of course,
our Facebook and Instagram page accounts. Yep. If you have not yet followed us or you've not yet visited our Facebook and Instagram accounts, do so. Look for Herbs of the Earth on Facebook and Instagram. If you'd like to visit our website, do so at www.herbsoftheearth.com. We also have a sister site that you can visit as well. It's www.fitbinge.com. In our next live episode, we will be posting links so that you can click on that immediately after viewing. You can also find us on our merchant partner sites like Lazada. Follow our store and chat with us. If you have made your orders through our site, please message us either through the site itself or through our Facebook account. If you've ordered through our merchant partners, we have actual teams handling our merchant partner sites. So send them a question, send them a message. If you need a follow-up, guys, we receive an overwhelming amount of messages on a daily basis. But rest assured, we will get back to you. We are open from Mondays to Fridays, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. And on Saturdays, we're open from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. And we are closed on Sundays for rest, for praise and worship, because it is our church day. So if you made an order, you made a question, you sent us a question, you sent us a message, rest assured we will get back to you anytime within the weekend or for sure on Monday morning.
Yes.
The same holds true for our merchant partner sites as well, guys. Okay?
Right. So again, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, this wonderful Saturday afternoon.
Yes.
Stay home. Stay fit.
Yes.
And if you're going back to the workplace, just don't forget the toolkit and the tools that we've talked about in this episode. And we just pray for safety for everyone as we go out into the workforce once again. And thank you so much for tuning in. We're going to see you again next week.
So Dave says, peace and cheers to also the Kahund people.
Yeah, the Kahund people like us. Have a wonderful afternoon, everyone.
Yeah.
Have a wonderful church day tomorrow.
Yes.
God bless you
all. God bless you all. Stay safe and healthy, guys.
Bye-bye. Bye.